Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to a new video. Today's video is going to be a completely honest review on this cage, the Critter Nation, that I have for my rats. My darling, I love you, I love you, I love you. So I want to start off by saying this is the double version of this cage, which means it has two levels, and it is home to my four female rats. We have Chamomile, Sunday, and then Maya and Twig are in this hammock. But this cage can hold up to, like, I think like 12 rats maximum. I would only ever put like a maximum of 10 in here, but it can hold up to 12. So the first thing that I'm going to start off by talking about is the price and where you can get it. So the single runs for about $170 on average at its lowest, and the double is about $273, and then the add-on you can get to make the single into the double is about $176, and those are all Amazon prices, which are fairly low for this cage. You can also get it from Walmart, Chewy, and eBay, and a few other sellers, but those aren't quite as, like, common. Since it is quite expensive, I would recommend getting it, secondhand. I didn't know that you could get rat cages secondhand when I first got rats, so I got mine from Amazon, and I started with the single, but I eventually ended up getting another single and made it into a double. Okay, so now some reasons that it's popular. The Critter Nation is a very, very popular rat cage, especially the double, because it is just so ridiculously spacious. So the first reason is that it is very widely available. You can get it on Amazon. It's hardly ever out of stock. I don't think I've ever looked and it's out of stock. It is super large, which is like the main reason. It's just a very suitable sized rat cage, which there aren't a ton of on the market since rats are a very misunderstood type of animal. And then the last reason is that it's super sturdy. It's a very high quality cage along with being very large. It's also very high quality, so that's really nice. Now we're going to move on to some pros and cons. So I'm going to start with pros. My first pro is obviously that it's an amazing size. I think the single size can hold up to 6 rats and the double can hold up to 12. For me personally, I would only put like 5 rats in the single and 10 in the double, but that's up to you. Next is that it's very high quality. I already mentioned this again, but it is a very, very high quality cage. And that's something that I really, really like about it. My next pro is that you can add onto it. You can make these cages as large as you could possibly want them to be. You can make as many stories as you want, and you can make it as wide as you want. I am not probably ever going to go any bigger than a double, just because I don't plan on having enough rats that, like, I would need to go bigger than that. And the double already takes up quite a lot of room in my room. But if you wanted to, like if you're a breeder or a rescue, you can add onto these cages as much as you like and make them like really huge, which also makes them a really good option for sugar gliders and chinchillas and larger animals like that. One of my biggest pros about this cage is that it has the, the front opening doors that open all the way. As you can see, you can open both of them and the entire front is open, because a lot of small animal cages only have a tiny little door in the middle. But what's really nice about this cage is you can open all four doors and have the entire thing completely open, and this makes cleaning so, so easy. And that's something that I really like about it. Next pro is that there is storage underneath, which I really, really like. Sorry, my storage is very messy right now because my bunny Milky really likes to dig at their fleece, but I really like the storage underneath, which, by the way, is optional. You don't have to have the storage underneath if you don't want to, but I personally use this to store all of their fleece as bedding. And my last pro for this cage is that it is on wheels. As you can see, it's a very large cage, and if it wasn't on wheels, it would be ridiculously hard to move. You'd probably need multiple people, but I can just slide it around whenever I want. I'm only 13 and I'm definitely not like ridiculously strong or anything. So yeah, it is very, very easy to move around since it is on wheels, which again are optional. You don't have to add the wheels, but they are super duper helpful. Okay, so now we're moving on to cons. I don't really have very many cons on this cage, and if I do, they are very minor cons that really wouldn't like put you off from buying it. So my first con is that the doors are very squeaky. As you can see, they make a lot of noise, and when you open them and you close them, you have to pop this part into place. I don't know if that's how everybody's cage is, but both of these doors and this door both have it. This is the only door that I don't have to pop back into place, and it still squeaks. So obviously that isn't like a super off-putting con, but it is there and it is something to keep in mind. Okay, so this is definitely one of my biggest cons. It's not super easy for me to show you, But this big bin down here is actually a cement mixing tub. It did not come with the cage. I think it was like $6, so it's not super expensive, but it didn't come with the cage. What came with the cage was another panel like this. I don't know if you can see these panels, but they're just these black plastic panels. They're about an inch thick, so they really don't hold loose bedding very well. So what I use with them is fleece. But if you want to use loose bedding in your entire cage, we'll have to find a solution for that. They make little, I can't remember, they might be scatter guards would be the name of them. But they are made by the Midwest brand, which is the brand that makes this cage. But they work absolutely horribly, and I really do not recommend getting them. I would recommend getting a cement mixing tub and then, like, another solution for these two. I don't know exactly what you could do with those, but I know there are options, like, on Etsy and, like, local businesses and stuff. Okay, so our next con is pretty obvious, and that is that it's a very, very expensive cage, as I mentioned earlier, so I know it's not really available to everyone. I think I already mentioned this, but you can get this cage secondhand, like off Craigslist or eBay or somewhere like that. I would really, really recommend looking somewhere like that, because a lot of the times you can find really, really good deals. I know Shadow the Rat found her double. I can't remember exactly how much it was, but it was ridiculously cheap, like under 100 if not free. I cannot remember. But there are always, like, really amazing deals like that on Craigslist and stuff if you want to find a double Critter Nation or single for a lot cheaper. Okay, now my last con is that the cage can be kind of hard to assemble. Some of the panels and, like, pieces and stuff can get warped during shipping, so that can make it a little bit annoying to put together. So I would recommend having, like, a rubber mallet or something with you when you're assembling it so that you can, like, sort of hit them a little bit into place. Once it is built, it is really, really sturdy, but it can be a little bit hard to put together. So yeah, overall, I would say that this is a really, really great cage and that it was 100% worth the money. It is just so spacious, and I'm sure your rats will love it. I would say if you want a large cage, sturdy, and you're planning on having rats for a long time, I would say go ahead and get it. It's such an amazing cage, especially when you find it secondhand. That is all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Bye! Say bye, good baby. Say bye, Maya. Oh, pause.